Waste electronics are one of the fastest growing waste streams on the planet, and LCDs within this are one of the fastest selling devices. And every year, 200 million LCDs are sold, and that's a huge amount. And these LCDs contain hazardous substances, mercury and liquid crystals, which have to be removed at the end of their life. And it's such an important issue and a threat to the environment and our well-being that the EC have made it mandatory to recycle and remove these substances when the devices come to the end of life. So the ALR 4000 is designed to depollute the LCDs of the components that contain the hazardous substances, liquid crystals and mercury. And it does this at an incredibly high throughput of 60 LCDs per hour compared to manual, which is doing around 3 to 5 LCDs per hour. And this means that you can remove the manual labour element and not expose workers to cuts or lacerations from dealing with the glass fractions, and also minimise their exposure to the hazardous materials.
This is one of those classic applications where the process itself is dangerous. You're handling LCD screens, LED screens, you know, there's toxic chemicals coming from it, there's minerals in there that humans should not be in contact with. So this is an ideal application for robotics. You know, they don't smell noxious chemicals, they don't generally speaking get affected, by the chemicals, especially if they're properly prepared for it. So it's a perfect project and a perfect application for robotics.
LCDs come in a massive amount of variety. They have different shapes and sizes, makes and models. They can contain over 150 screws, and they can have different fastening devices, from glue to sticky tape to cable ties. They can have speakers on the tops and bottoms, and even a DVD player on the back. So it's a lot of variation to be able to handle. So we've undertaken 4 technology development rounds to make a robust machine that can deal with the variety of different LCDs.
We needed a robot that was going to be very, very rigid, very reliable, very repeatable, but that also had the capacity to handle quite large payloads and quite large tools. And the Quantex series of robots was actually the ideal choice for that. And it's 90% recyclable. The robot itself is 90% recyclable. It's probably our most green robot, and one of the ones that we're most proud of, and it's fitting into, in a waste recycling environment. So it fits well.
Our machines are going into recycling facilities that are very robust environments, and there often isn't a lot of automation expertise in-house in these facilities. So it was very important that we have a very reliable robot that is very well supported. We are deploying machines internationally, and what was a really big aspect for us was the ability of KUKA to support our machines internationally on the robotic side. So we've increased the functionality of the machine, from processing LCD TVs to also LCD monitors and LED displays. In addition, we have a fully built-in carbon filtration system, and our focus was to make the machine plug and play to drop at site, where you can hook up air and electricity supply and the emissions point, and then the machine is good to go as a self-contained LCD recycling plant. The whole world is moving towards circular economy, and Europe is really leading the way with initiatives such as the Green Deal and Circular Economy Action Plan. And it's really required in order to get our materials back from the products that we're currently using and get them back into circularity. And it really is the backbone, the recycling piece and element. And we really see technology such as ours as leading the way for high throughput processing to liberate the valuable materials, but also to depollute and capture those hazardous materials.
Industrial intelligence.